Alright guys, and welcome back to another Dragon Ball Z Dual Combat video. This time we're back in Extreme Super Battle Road or Super Battle Road, and we're taking on the Vegeta's family event. This is probably the hardest event out of all of the stages. The Goku's family one was quite difficult, but this one was really, really difficult. You really need a strong defensive team, and Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, he's good, but he's just not got the... He hasn't got enough defense for a lot of these... for a lot of these actual enemies, you know, and there's a lot of AGO type enemies as well, so it kind of makes it quite difficult on Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, but he's still a powerhouse, so I'm gonna go ahead and pop his active skill. The real fight begins now. No one can stop me now. Final shine, attack! There we go. Alright, is that gonna do enough damage? Nope. But we'll finish him off with this next active skill here. There we go, there's the second one. So active skills really make it very, very, it makes a Vegeta very usable, especially the Super Saiyan 4 one, because his entire team's all about defensive and tanking until you can get his active skill off and a lot of damage. So I'm going to show you guys the team that I used, but there we go. We've got the Vegeta's family event completely done there, completely crushed it. Vegeta's family only. So this is one of the brand new stages. As always, guys, if you're enjoying all of my Dragon Ball Z Dual Combat content, don't forget to leave a like. There's a full playlist in the description down below for every Super Battle Road stage that I've done so far. There's only two or three more Super Battle Road stages left. Once you complete it, you get one Dragon Stone. And then afterwards, in your missions, once you collect your missions, you get an additional 5 more Dragon Stones and a Victory's Light, which you can exchange for either the Equipments, Elder Kai's, or Zenny. Yep. So you can go ahead and grab those. So confirm, absolutely wonderful. And then I want to show you guys my team. So here's the team, guys, that I used to beat the event itself. I'm using Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta as the leader, Vegeta's family leader. The only issue that I have with this is instead, the best leader skill you're looking for is 170 or 150 in attack and defense. I mean, not attack and defense, sorry, HP and defense. You want high HP and defense. Unfortunately, Vegeta gives 130 to HP. So it'd be cool if they bring a Vegeta's family category leader that came with 150 HP, 170 attack, and 150 defense. That'd be nice. But yeah, Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, he hits really hard. He defends quite well. But his problem is he's not tanky enough. Only 11k defense. But the thing is, my one, I need more dupes inside him. The friend one was very tanky. Now, the tankiness is made up thanks to this Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta. This guy has a high chance of stunning, so I've given him loads of additionals. Check out all these additionals, 15 additional. I'm even going to put even some more additional onto this guy. And then, so he has a high chance of stunning, and then reduces damage by 80%. So if this guy gets super attacked multiple times, he'll only take like 50, 60, maybe 1,000 damage at most. He's just ridiculously tanky, and then he can do that for 10 turns, which is perfectly fine because the fight will be over about 5-6 turns later, so you know. Next up, I have Majin Vegeta stunning, the Mega Colossal super attack. He just does really high damage, and we've got a lot of strength type enemies in there as well, so Majin Vegeta is really, really excellent. Next up, we have the Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan Vegeta. This guy is just an amazing character. So he raises attack and defense by 50% for 3 turns, right? And then he just does a whole bunch of extra debuffs on extreme class, high chance to stun an enemy. You know, he does a lot of stuff. But it's mostly against the Goku's family, but he's still really strong here. He's very strong. And he's an easier unit. And then next up, this guy is very clutch. Very powerful. You could use this one, or you could use the Tech Super Saiyan 2 Vegeta. You can use either of them, but I think this guy is the superior one when it comes to defensiveness. As soon as he gets hit 1, 2, 3 times, he's taking no more damage after that, because he raises attack and defense by 30% for 6 turns, and then on top of that, he has 90% attack and defense and an additional 15% with each attack received up to 60%. So he gets 150% defense with this stack. Absolutely ridiculous. And then he has a really high defensive number as well. Look at that, very high defense, so he's excellent. And then I'm using support Trunks. You guys can fill out any other character you want here, but I do find that Vegeta's family teams, they struggle with ki, so support Trunks is good. Just keep him out of the way of any attacks, but he will give himself a decent amount of buff. He gets 70% attack and defense, and then the additional 30% as well all allies. So he can go up to 100% if there's Vegeta family, and the entire team is Vegeta family. So there's the team that I used, guys. Hopefully this helps you out. If we was to change any characters and think about any other characters you'd want to actually put on the team, this Trunks is very good as well, because he's defensively very strong, raises defense, he tanks, he reduces damage as well. If I had him 100%, yeah, I'd use him. Who else is very good as well? This guy is absolutely amazing, Super Saiyan 2 Vegeta, but we're using the AGL one. If you guys want to bring this guy is excellent. He's so good, so good. I could bring the Evolution Vegeta, but I do think that the Int one's better, because we have Tech Goku in the second fight, which is really hard to deal with, and this guy makes short work of that Tech Goku, so he's absolutely amazing. And then all the other characters, there are some Heroes units as well that I tried it out with. They are very good, but unfortunately the Heroes units require to use more Heroes characters, so you're better off just using this team here. And also this guy, if you don't have LR Majin Vegeta, if you have this Majin Vegeta, he is absolutely bonkers nuts. Stuns, super attacks, hits all, you know, he's really, really good. This guy's really good. So once he goes easier, he was really good. But yeah, as always, guys, that's pretty much the video today. Hopefully you guys managed to make a good team and beat it. If you guys managed to beat it with a different team, please let people know in the comment section down below what team you used to beat this actual stage itself. There's only a few more stages left for me to actually do. Let me just quickly check right now. And then, yeah, if you guys are struggling on any of the other stages, the guides are already up and everything, so make sure you guys check them out. So, yeah, we've only got 3 more stages to go. Crazy. Yeah, only 3 more stages. Beat everything else. So, yeah, 3 more stages to go. Yeah, go ahead and check out all the other videos. Next up, I'm going to be covering Youth, Super Saiyans, and Final Trump Card. I think Super Saiyan's going to be hella easy. Don't know about Final Trump Card. I've seen some people complete Final Trump Card in about 6 turns, so can't be too hard. But Vegeta's family and Goku's family are definitely the 2 hardest stages. So if you guys are struggling, Goku's family, I've already done it. It's in the playlist. Check out the link in the description below. As always, guys, thank you very much for tuning in. I'll see you guys on the next DragonBallZ.com video. Peace out.